Hello everyone, this is theory of electrical machine class. Now we will study about the efficiency of DC machine. Now efficiency of DC machine, in this part we will study about two topic, that is motor and generator. Separately we will do. Now first we will take what is the formula of DC machine. There are three types of efficiency which we actually relate. The first one is mechanical efficiency. You can see here, it is given by eta m. Now the eta, it is the symbol of efficiency. This is the eta, that is the m long leg, that is eta. This m signifies mechanical. So eta m, this is mechanical efficiency. Now if we start with the mechanical efficiency formula, this given here, we can see electrical power developed by armature and total divided by total mechanical power input. So we have to, this is the ratio of two things. Upper is the electrical power developed by armature and lower is mechanical power input. If we take the formula in this case, so we can see it is EGIA. Just 1 minute, one thing. Whatever this equation we are giving, this is for generator. These equations are for generator. So starting here, electrical power developed by armature. So this is power. So that will be voltage multiplied by current. So what we see, this is again given the same EG into IA. That is the potential in armature, what is given. For generator, this is G. G is for generator. So whatever the potential, and current is denoted by I. So armature current IA, and mechanical power input, that we can see here, mechanical power input is given by BHP of prime mover into 735.5. This is the equation, okay, which we have derived earlier. So we can just write whatever the formula. In this formula 735.5, this term is there. So this is mechanical efficiency. Next we coming for the electrical efficiency. Now electrical efficiency again has the symbol eta, but the coefficient here we can see it is given as E. So E means electrical. Just like previously M was given as mechanical, same thing, E is given as electrical. Now eta E, that is electrical efficiency, that is useful electrical power output divided by electrical power developed. So efficiency in terms of eta, we can see whatever the output of useful electrical power which we can use, electrical power which is at the output, divided by what are the electrical power developed. So output we can give like V into I is the power, and electrical power developed, so this is EG into IA. So EG into IA, that is the whatever the electrical power developed. So same thing we can see here also, electrical power developed EGIA. So same formula here also given, that is EGIA. This is the electrical efficiency. And next, number third, it is given commercial efficiency. Okay, commercial efficiency, or we also say like it is overall. Actually, this is the two term we already see here. It is mechanical efficiency, electrical efficiency. Both these two term are taken together in this term. So we can see here. First, it is overall or commercial efficiency. The formula, first we can see, it is given useful electrical power output divided by total mechanical power input. So obviously, in this case of whatever the final output, that is electrical power. In case of generator, we can see that final output of generator is to produce electricity. So that means useful electrical power output, how much electrical power we can actually use, that is the upper side, and lower side is total mechanical power input, that is the input to, you know, in generator we give mechanical. So in generator mechanical power is converted to electrical power. So divided by total mechanical power input, this is the efficiency, that is overall or commercial efficiency. Now here also we can see one term is given, this overall or commercial efficiency, it is given as the multiplication of the previous two term we have just seen, that is mechanical efficiency and electrical efficiency. And we also have seen the equations for them also. So it is we can see here, this is EGIA at the bottom and this is EGIA at the top. So whenever we multiply both of them, so this EGIA top and this EGIA bottom is cancelled out. So top we are having V into I, that is here, and at the bottom O we can see. So as this is cancelled out, so only this one, that is BHP of principal, that is primer mover, into 735.5. So that is giving BHP of primer mover 735.5. So just previous two term is multiplied here, and that is given as overall efficiency. So here we can see some other expression is also given for generator. This is the mathematical expression for overall efficiency, and theoretically it can be expressed like this one also. The overall efficiency, it is eta og equal to useful power output divided by useful power output plus total losses. So that is the efficiency, because in we can see in efficiency that how much finally power is useful for us, it is a useful power output, that is VI, we know from the previous equation, and divided by useful power output plus total losses. So that is the, if we add the losses also, so we can have how much total power is given. So that is the power we are using plus losses. So if this is we are taking combined useful power output plus total loss, these two if we combine, and useful power output divided by this combination, this is also another expression for total or overall efficiency. So in this format, obviously our expression is Vi divided by Vi plus total losses, and the terms we used previously, that is EG, that is the generated EMF. So generated, that means for generator. So this is for generator, it is G. So whatever the E, that is the potential. So EMF, here we can see the generated EMF is EG. We have already seen in the previous equations. And the V, whatever we are always using, here the term V, that is the terminal voltage. I, whenever we use here and here, this I term is load current, and I suffix A, this A is for armature, so IA is armature, so this is armature current. Now one expression is given, that for good generator, the value of overall or commercial efficiency may be as high as 95%. So we can see the losses are very low in case of very high quality generator, and it can go up to 95%. So Vi divided by Vi plus total loss, so losses is less, so we can have up to 95%. Up to 95% total efficiency we can have. Now we come to motor. Now we have seen three equations for generator, that is electrical efficiency, mechanical efficiency, and overall efficiency. Now the same three things we will have for the motor. The motor, first thing is electrical efficiency. Again, it is given as E, suffix E, eta suffix E. This is for electrical efficiency. Now it is mechanical power developed by total electrical power input. Just we compare with electrical efficiency of generator. So electrical efficiency of generator is total electrical power output, useful electrical power output divided by electrical power developed. And for motor, it is mechanical power developed divided by total electrical power input. Now it is, we can see the expression is also given. For mechanical power developed, it is given by EV into IA, and total electrical power input, this is V into I. Now coming to mechanical efficiency, this mechanical efficiency eta M, the M is for mechanical. This mechanical efficiency is the ratio of useful mechanical power output divided by mechanical power developed. We are taking useful portion of mechanical power output, which we can use it. If we divided it by mechanical power developed, so that ratio is our mechanical efficiency. Again, we can see here, the expression useful mechanical power output, this is BHP of motor into 735.5, this is the expression we have already seen previously, divided by EBIA, this is the mechanical power developed, this is EBIA. So if we take the ratio of BHP of motor into 735.5, is the expression, divided by EBIA, this is called mechanical efficiency. Okay, only this we will do first. Overall or commercial efficiency, again we know that overall or commercial efficiency is the multiply of two term, that is the first two term, that is mechanical efficiency and electrical efficiency. This two if we multiply, we can have the overall efficiency. Now by expression we can see it is useful mechanical power output divided by total electrical power input. So we see it is a motor, so in motor our input is electrical power and output is mechanical power. So efficiency, if we say it is useful mechanical power output divided by total electrical power input, and if we multiply the previous two term, so we just see this is the electrical efficiency, this is the mechanical efficiency. If we multiply both of them, so it will be this into this. So EBIA top here, EBIA is bottom, so these two is multiplied and if this two will be cut, and so upper portion will be BHP of motor into 735.5 and lower will be VI, that is the multiplication of these two. So we can see the upper one is BHP of motor into 735.5, that is the upper portion of this, and this will be cut because here it is, this will be cut, so down portion will be VI. So we can see here the down expression is VI. This is the overall electrical and mechanical, that is which we call commercial efficiency. Commercial efficiency is electrical efficiency multiplied by mechanical efficiency. So this we can see the total expression is BHP of motor into 735.5 divided by VI. Now just like the previous case, here also the overall efficiency can be expressed in another term which is called useful power output divided by total power input. And useful power output, we know this is total power input minus total losses, because we are using the term useful, so that means what we can use, so that means after eliminating the losses. So this is total power input minus total losses and this is total power input. So VI minus total losses divided by VI, this is the for the case of total efficiency. Now what are the terms we used, that is EB is the back EMF, B is supply voltage, I is load current and IA is armature current. These are the terms we have used. Next we are using the condition for maximum efficiency. The first thing we should know, that the maximum efficiency condition for whatever it may be, DC motor or it may be DC generator. This is same in both cases. Now, we will first derive it for the case of DC generator. Now, generator power output we are taking as VI. So, power output, this is power. So, voltage multiplied by current, this is the generator power output. If flux and speed are constant, all losses expect. For example, we will first starting this in the case of generator. Power output is given as VI. So, if we take case of the losses, when flux and speed are constant, okay, except armature copper loss, only this term, that is armature copper loss, except this term, all the other losses is constant. So, we can write the expression like this, that losses equal to armature copper loss plus constant loss. Okay. So, if flux and speed are constant, all losses except armature copper loss are constant. So, losses equal to armature copper loss plus constant loss. Now, we can write this like that. From this equation it is given, we can simply say that I plus ISH whole square into RA plus PC. Now, ISH is small and its square is also very small, so we just neglect it. So, it will be I square RA plus PC. So, we are neglecting ISH in comparison with load current I. We will compare I, ISH is very small. So, square term that we are neglecting, and the 2 times I into ISH, that we are also neglecting because the value of ISH is small. Now, the terms ISH is the shunt field current, and P denotes constant losses which include iron loss, field winding loss and mechanical loss. So, these three are included: iron loss, field winding loss and mechanical loss. These three losses are included. So, we can write like this: efficiency eta equal to output by input, that is output by output plus losses. So, we just write the equations. Output is V into I, and at the bottom side VI plus losses we can write I square RA plus PC. So, if this is the expression, obviously if it is differentiated, if it is, it will be 0. So, it has maximum when DDI of eta equal to 0. So, we just differentiate it with respect to I. So, we have this term after differentiating, and from this term we can come to the conclusion that I square RA equal to PC. So, from here we can write that efficiency would be maximum when variable losses are equal to constant loss, or from here you can see I equal to PC by RA, I square equal to PC by RA. So, I equal to root over of pc by ra, pc by ra. So this is given in this equation. Thus the efficiency increases with increasing load current, reaches a maximum value when load current equals the value given by equation 27, and then starts decreasing. So from this equation we can write, next we will take the efficiency curve. So here the expression and the graph is given for efficiency. Efficiency curve, the efficiency of a machine is different at different values of power output. As the output increases, the efficiency increases till it reaches a maximum value. So you can see, as the output increases, as the output is increasing, the efficiency also increases up to maximum value. So as the output increases, the efficiency increases till it reaches a maximum value. As the output is further increased, the efficiency start decreasing. So you can see, after this point, output, if it is still increased, this graph is decreasing. As the output is further increased, the efficiency start decreasing. A graph of efficiency versus output is called efficiency curve. Efficiency curve is generally efficiency versus output curve, and this is plotted here. We can see a typical efficiency curve is shown in the figure. The machine are so designed as to give maximum efficiency at or near the rated output of the machine. Since the generator operates at a constant terminal voltage V, okay, since the generator operates at a constant terminal voltage V, the terminal voltage is constant. The efficiency curve of a generator can be drawn between efficiency and load current I. It can also be drawn. So here we have seen the efficiency curve. So just one time we have seen the total things what we have studied today. In today's lecture, we have taken the equation of efficiency, and we know efficiency is of three type, that is electrical efficiency, mechanical efficiency, and overall efficiency. That is the quantification of first two terms. Now we are taking first with generator. In today's lecture, we have seen the equation of generator, maximum efficiency expression for generator. The first one is, today we learned about mechanical efficiency, then electrical efficiency, and then commercial efficiency, and we have seen another expression of commercial efficiency also. Next, coming to motor, this is again the expression. We can see electrical efficiency, mechanical efficiency, and overall or commercial efficiency. In this case also, same term commercial efficiency is given in this term also, and we can see the expression for maximum efficiency. This is the expression for maximum efficiency, and the same expression is same for generator as well as motor. And next we have seen the efficiency curve, that is the output versus percentage efficiency graph. So we can see with output this graph first increases then decreases. So this is the overview of what today, or summary of what today we have learned about the different type of efficiency of DC machine, that is generator and motor. Thank you.